This is video part two, and I will be getting towards the signs of Capricorn, Aquarius and Pisces when it comes to the full moon and a new moon. So the full moon in Cancer and a new moon eclipse in your sign Capricorn. This is all about you, right? I already said it. If you've got a birthday around the 5th, 6th to 7th of January, wow! You won't be able to recognize yourself after this year has evolved. I mean, there's so much of you Capricorn people, but not only the ones who have a birthday on that, you know, every Capricorn will feel it because it's so many planets conjuncting each other in your sign and with the south node. So for Capricorn, let go of those old structures and just go with the flow with that. So if you're feeling that things are absolutely not going for you anymore because the first house is your path, please let go of it. And it could be initiated by a person who's very close to you, because your seventh house is Cancer and you're getting that full moon there. So someone else is in the spotlight and someone else is showing you what they're all about, and that has an impact on you. So even when you are not in a relationship, it could be that someone is really important at this time. There's certainly someone there that is highly important for you, and that shows you everything about comfort, about your needs, about what you want in life. And that has a knock-on effect on you as a person, on your identity, because you want to change your identity. And even more than that, I hope you want to change your identity in a deconstruction of parts of yourself that are no longer working for you, in order for you to get that out, that stronger version of you, because that's what it's all about. It's about showing your potential at its strongest. But there are parts of you that you, the way that you react, the way that you show yourself, the way that you want your life to unfold, that needs to go. So what is it in your life, dear Capricorns, that you're saying this is absolutely not working anymore? It could be, as it's your first house, it could be almost anything, you know, your life path. So for a lot of you, it will be work. For others, it will be relationship. And even for other people, it will be their attitude towards certain things in life. And that needs to go. So a lot of change for the Capricorns. And the better is to embrace it. The better is to, you know, if you see that things are deconstructing in a lot of areas of your life, and it's try to see it in a good way. Of course, it's easy to say so for me when it's a pleasant thing that is deconstructing. If you're, for instance, not wanting a job anymore and they are firing you, and they are, you know, they can give you another job in another company, great, you know. But if it's something that is leaving you and you identify so much with it, maybe you identify yourself in a certain role of being always the parent, or being always the doctor that you are, or being always this or that, maybe you need to distance yourself a little bit of those roles. So it has a lot to do with roles that you are playing, and are they worth it to keep them playing? You know, it's a question. You have an opportunity now to the roles that you're feeling not okay with, to adjust that. That's the beauty of this this eclipse. So work with it and certainly don't go against it, because, you know, you cannot. There's a lot of transformation going on. And with transformation, if you're working against it, you cannot work against death, so to speak. So which doesn't mean that you're gonna die. I mean, not at all, but it means that parts of you are dying. So say goodbye to them so you can have new ones who are way more exciting for you. I've put a little bit more effort here for the Capricorn because it's so important for you, okay? But there will be something happening with another person that is close to you that makes you realize even more, I've got to change myself. So it's a lot about, I don't want to say that it's all you. I don't want to give you guilt or whatever. I mean, that's already a subject for the Capricorns that's already very sensitive. But someone can help you in seeing all parts of you that need to go. Anyway, next sign is Aquarius. Aquarius, this full moon is happening in your sixth house. And then this all this energy in Capricorn is happening in your 12th house. So for Aquarius, what does it mean? It means that, now it could be very clear, and the sun is shining so brightly now. It's very clear that when it comes to your work, your daily routines, something becomes very obvious now. So maybe, and you know, as it is a full moon and it's a very realistic full moon, because remember it opposes Saturn, I think a lot of you Aquarians will see now the benefits of the hard work that you've been doing this year, and that you will feel that there is a lot of fruition there. There's a lot of things that you can really cherish that has to do with your daily routines. So there is something about your routines, your work, that you're saying, I didn't do so bad. You see what I mean? It's quite a positive energy there. Now that other, or health, you know, it could mean that you're now seeing, huh, because I worked hard this year on my body, you know, I did some exercises or whatever, now I'm seeing the results of it, and look how I look, or whatever it is that you wanted to accomplish. There is something that you see now that is very, very clear to you, and that has to do with your health, that has to do with your work, your habits, and it's quite okay what you're seeing. And now the new moon and the eclipse in your 12th house, it's a lot about ending karma. You're ending, the Aquarians are the ones who are ending the most cycles of karma. So that can be a very good thing when cycles end. Why is that? Because it's Saturn who's there as well, Pluto who is there as well, the South. Now, these are all kind of harsh planets and points. And that means that the karma that is ending is karma that was quite heavy on you. So you might end a certain part of your job, maybe not the whole job, but a certain part of your job that you're saying, I'm glad that is finished now. Okay, it was a big responsibility, but I'm feeling good about it. And I'm glad that someone else is doing it, for instance. So that kind of energy is going on for the Aquarians. There is a huge possibility now to release, to be spiritual, to feel connected with all that is, which Aquarians can do quite in a very practical way even. They feel it almost, because it's very tangible. It's in an earth sign. It's Capricorn. You can feel it. So it's a nice eclipse for you. And especially if you worked hard in the past, of all those roles that you had, or responsibilities that you had that have almost become a burden, you can now round it up and say goodbye to it, which is great. Also, like addictions, you know, that's the 12th house. The circle is around the addiction. It's done. You're not addicted anymore. You've done what you've could. It's related to that 6th house, remember. So you could have done quite a big deal in 2018, considering your health, and now you're seeing it's gone. I can let go of that. So it's always on a karmic level, I always find when the South Node is in the 12th house and you know, with a constellation like this now, I think a lot of Aquarians will be able to say goodbye to a lot of their addictions, you know, whether it is smoking or whether it is a big or a small addiction. So that's a good sign. And for last but not least, the Pisces, this is happening in their 11th house and in their 5th house. So this full moon in Cancer, it's a fellow water sign, which is great. This is happening in your 5th house. So you could be having the greatest time, but a very practical time as well when it comes to what you love to do. The 5th house is the house of restaurants and cafes and getting along with people that you like, that... So there could be something becoming very clear about how you enjoy yourself, and in a positive way, in a very realistic way. There could be an accomplishment that you said, that of a project, or there could be something becoming very clear around the child, and it really is rewarding. Or there could be happening something about your love life. You know, you could really fall in love now, you Pisceans, and in a very practical way. I mean, it's down to words. It's not that fluffy love that, oh, you're dreaming and you're not experiencing. No, there's something about it that you're truly experiencing. And that is fantastic. And then all that deconstruction of a structure for you. It's not in the biggest part of your chart. It has to do with your 11th house. So there could be an objective that you're letting go of that was really a burden. So maybe you decided to do a study or to do a job that was quite heavy on you, and now you've said, you know, I'm never ever gonna do that again. I'm just letting go of that desire that I had, and that's good. It could come with a feeling of relief even. So maybe you said to yourself, look, I'm going to study for nurse, and you know, because I want to be a nurse. But then you're realizing, no, it's too much pressure. I have four children and I have a renovation of a home. I have to be practical. I have to let go of that desire. And maybe, you know, next year or within a couple of years, I'll pick it up again. Or I might never, ever pick it up. It's probably more like that. I will never, ever pick it up because it's so karmic. So when we have desires, because the 11th house is a lot about the future, it's a lot about how we see the future. There's a lot for you Pisces that you're letting go of the desires. And you could say, oh, that's a bit sad. Yeah, it could be sad on another thing, on another level. It's a relief. It's a relief that you're not putting pressure on yourself. Maybe because of certain circumstances that show yourself now, maybe you're not having fun at all anymore. And because of that, you're letting go of a very objective that was weighing very heavy on your shoulders. You see, maybe you were wanting that promotion and now you're saying, promotion? I'm already up to here and I don't see my children or my wife or my husband or whatever. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to let go of that objective and I'm going to feel more free and feel better about myself. So something like that could be happening. Or, of course, connections with friends, connections with maybe you're ending a friendship. Maybe you are disconnecting from social media. You know, it's maybe Facebook or maybe websites, or in order for you to have a new maybe website or whatever it is, or maybe you're saying, no, that's not the thing for me, etc., etc. So it's not the biggest life-changing energy for you, but it's one that is really, that can give you a lot of new structure in the future that is more adapted towards your reality now. Having said that, I wish you all the best. I wish you such a good eclipse, and thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.